गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन लेक्चर ऑफ क्लास सिक्स साइंस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट फ्लावर्स। वी विल सी व्हाट डज फ्लावर मीन्स, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ फ्लावर्स। वी आर गोइंग टू बी इन डेप्थ, ओके, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी दिस टॉपिक इन डिटेल। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट इट। यू आर शोन थ्री ब्रांचेस ऑफ अ रोज in figure 7.19 a, b and c. Which one will help you the best to recognize the plant? So here three figures are given and we are asked which will help you the best to recognize the plant. So consider the a figure. If you are given such stem only, can you recognize the plant? No, right? Now if you are given stem with having some leaves, so is it possible? Yes, slightly. But if it is given with this type of figure 6, which consists of stem, leaves and flowers, then you will identify quickly that it is a rose plant. Which color did you use for the flower in figure 7.19? See, are all flowers colorful? Have you ever seen flowers on grass, wheat, maize, mango or guava? Are those brightly colored? Let us study a few flowers. Okay, so here are a bunch of questions which we will answer. Now let's see activity number 10. Starting from activity number 10, we would require one bird and two fresh flowers each of any of the following: the tura, china rose, mustard, brinjal, lady's finger, gulmohar, also a blade, a glass slide or a sheet of paper, a magnifying glass and water. So this all thing we are going to have. Observe figure 7.20 carefully. So here is the figure 7.20, bird and a flower. Look at the prominent parts of a open flower. These are petals, okay. So the open parts of the flower here, these are the open parts, right? These are the open parts. This is called petal. So we have studied one part of a flower which is called petals. And what are they? The prominent parts of the open flower. These are the petals. Different flowers have petals of different colors. Yes, we know this. Red rose having the red petals, pink roses have the pink petals, yellow roses have yellow petals. Okay. So you know this. Where do you think the petals are in the close bud? Which is the most prominent part in the bud? Did you see that this part is made up of small leaf like structure? So how they are hold on in the bud? They are hold by this structure, the green structure, here you can see this part, which is called sepals or sepals. They are called sepals. Take a flower and observe its petals and sepals. Now you can do it. If you can easily see the petals, okay, but if you are having difficulty of seeing the sepals, then just remove all the petals and the remaining part will be the sepals. Okay, take a flower and observe its petals and sepals. Now answer the following question. So this is an activity which you have to do at your home. Take one flower and try to answer all this question. How many sepals does it have? Are they joined together? What are the color of the petals and the sepals? Okay, take any one flower and try to answer all this question. How many petals does the flower have? Are they joined to one another or are separated? Do the flowers with joints sepals have petals that are separated, or are they also joined together? Fill the table based on the observation of the whole class. Add observation to this table from a field trip to a locality where there are plants with flower. So in this pandemic, we can't gather. So you can do it by your own self if possible. This is not a compulsory activity. Fill the last two columns later. Okay, so try to fill this first five columns. Okay, ignore these two for now, because you know, you don't know what are they are. To see the inner part of the flower clearly, you have to cut it open if its petals are joined. Okay, for example, in the Datura and other bell shaped flowers, the petals have to be cut lengthwise and spread out so that inner part can be seen clearly. Figure 7.21. Okay, so here you have to cut this flower parallelly. Okay, from this you have to take one petal from the other. Okay, and try to remove the petals. Remove the sepals and petals to see the other parts. Study the figure 7.22 carefully. Compare your flower with the illustration and identify the stamens and pistil in your flower. So now, when you will remove these sepals and petals, right? You will see this yellow structure. Okay, you will see this yellow structure. So in that, we have to learn three things. See, the middle portion, somewhat of green color, is called pistil. Then the other parts, okay, the anthers of yellow color, and the stamens, which is of cream color. So when you will remove the petals and sepals, you will see the inner part of the plant or flower, and there are total three: stamens, anthers, and pistil. So you will run three parts. Moving further, see a big picture. Okay, a magnified picture is shown. This is anther and this is filament, right? Okay, they have gone in detail of the stamen. So when you will zoom the stamen, you will find anther and the filament. The innermost part of the flower is called the pistil. If you cannot see it completely, remove the remaining stamens. Identify the parts of pistil with the help of 7.24. So this is the part of pistil. Uppermost part of the pistil is called as stigma. This stick-like structure is style, and this is ovary. Okay. Now moving to activity number 11. Let us now study the structure of ovary. It is the lowermost and the swollen part of the pistil. We will cut the part to study what is inside. Now look at the figure at 7.25a and be carefully to understand how to cut ovary of a flower. So when you got the pistil, you have to cut it like this way and this way. One horizontal and one vertical cut in two different pistil. Cut the ovary into two different ways as shown in figure 7.25. To prevent them from drying, put a drop of water on each of the two pieces of the ovary. You have a cut. Now see, when you will cut the ovary part horizontally, you will see this type of structure, and you will cut the, when you will cut the ovary vertically, then you will see this type of structure. So what is this? Let's see. Observe the inner part of the ovary using a lens or a magnifying glass. Do you see some small beads like structure inside the ovary? Okay, you will see this beads like structure. Here you can see this when we will cut it into the horizontal way. they are called ovules. So inside ovary, ovules are there. Try to find out the name of as many as flower as you can by asking the gardener or any other person. Remember not to pluck more flowers than you need. So here is one activity which you can do. Based on what you have filled in 7.3 table, answer the following question. So once again, you have to do this by your own self. Okay. Do all flower have sepals, petals, stamens, and pistils? Are there flowers that do not have one or more of this? Are there flowers which have parts other than this? Okay, you have to see this. Did you find any other flowers which has no difference between the sepals and petals? Do you find any flowers in which the number of stamens is different from the number of petals? Do you now agree that the structure of the flower is not always the same? The number of sepals, petals, stamens, and pistils may also be different in different flowers. Some of these parts may even be absent at a time. Okay, so it is not necessary that all the parts we have studied till now will be present in a single flower. It can be there or it cannot be. We have studied some features and function of leaves, stems, and roots. We studied the structure of different flowers. We will learn about the function of flowers in higher classes. We will also learn about the fruits in the higher classes. So here we are ending our chapter. Thank you.